find me by the water, waiting for the trumpet call. Oh, you see me like a stranger. Well, I've been waiting for the storm, singing amen, amen, amen.
So I have a home boxing gym in my garage that was probably made from maybe under $1,000 at most. And today I'm gonna show you how you can make this gym and what you would need to do.
So obviously it's nothing insanely special. It's just some bags and some boxing equipment. We got a double end bag. We have a heavy bag filled with water. We have a unicycle for my core, and we have this other core thing. We have another boxing bag right over here. We have the Cobra bag, which a lot of you really love, getting pretty beat up. And then we have the spin bar bag. That's really bad. Last but not least, there is the speed bag, which I need to order a new one of, which I will make a video on. And then we just have some small sided equipment like a pull-up bar, some heavy row cones, dumbbell bars, and dumbbells, light ones. And then we have a big weight behind this picture. And then there's the boxing gloves, there's the wrap, there's the boxing ball, there's this thing, sweatsuit, bunch of cleats, and some other weights right over here. But just a lot of little stuff that make a gym what it is.
So my garage has always been really messy, like 2 years ago, and we just had a bunch of junk in it, which you can see, like this random dresser, a TV, but there was stuff just filled in the middle, like my sister's old clothes. And I was getting sick of it because like this space could be occupied for something so much more special that I could use every day. It still gets junky pretty fast, but as long as I keep it clean, it stays okay. So to start off, this bag right here was at a garage sale for $10. It works perfect. I just connected it to the top of my garage up there, and I put some weights at the bottom. This is probably like one of the things I use the most, and it's probably the best thing ever. But if you can't find one at a garage sale, you can go online and literally get one for $15. Like, even brand new, you can buy one for $50 if you get a good one. So that's $15 if you want one. We'll just average it. This Cobra bag was pretty expensive. Now they're getting cheaper, but this was, I believe, like $250. So we're at $275 right now. We got this bag, which I wouldn't recommend at all. It's probably the worst thing in the world. I hate it a lot. It doesn't help me with anything. I feel like maybe just ducking a little bit. And this was $280, I think. So we're at like six something. And then this V bag right here, the whole setup was, I believe, $20 or something at a garage sale. The bag popped after a couple days. Like I said, I've got a new one coming in the mail. And then all my dad did is put some 2x4s in the wall, found the studs, nailed it in, and then we got a nice sturdy bag. Also, it's only sturdy because we have the sand on top that we got from the hardware store, just to give it some more support, but it doesn't shake that much. Just this bag is broke, and when the new one comes in, it's much smaller. Then we have this trampoline that was also from a garage sale. I use this for like my quads and stuff, like balance techniques and stuff like that. That was like $5, I believe. It's really cheap stuff. And then this medicine ball, or not medicine ball, this air ball, whatever it is, I use that for my core, like bending over and stretching. That was probably $10 too. And we got this, which we got for free, and a gym gave it to us. And if you reach out to like gyms, they sometimes throw out equipment, and that's how we got that basically. This was, I believe, $10 at a garage sale. I use that a lot. It's for like rolling out and building your core. A pull-up bar, I had this for like years. And then last but not least, like the finishing touch is just basically the turf that we got at Home Depot for like $140. And no, we did not get all this at like one time. Like this has been like a collection for the last 2 years, like slowly building on. The gloves, like I got a bunch of separate times, and like the wraps. And like, if you're not looking to spend a lot of money, my suggestion is to start small, like clear space in your house, in your garage, and then lay like a little turf down so you know like what the area is declared. Slowly build up getting equipment just like this. Like obviously like I couldn't afford like just buying that much equipment right off the bat. It took me like a long time to be able to start all this, but I couldn't be more thankful because I come in here every night and I work out, and it's way better than going to a gym because I can just come in here, go upstairs, take a shower. And then I also have this bag that we bought at a garage sale. This stand and that bag costed $80. This bag ended up sucking. I didn't realize it at first because I know how to box. But this whole stand is $80, and it's holding this bag right now. And I have that bag right there, which is the same as this one, except that one cracked, so we got a new one. And then this one came in and it had a crack in it, so we ordered another one that's coming in. But yeah, so I got a job and now I can get more stuff because of that. Over time, you can definitely collect a lot of stuff. But if you're just starting with like a home gym, like the best thing I can say is clear space in your house, in your garage, wherever it is. Put maybe one or the two items of equipment you have, start using them, and then save your money. Go to garage sales, go on eBay, go on like Buffalo Craigslist and look under the free, or not Buffalo Craigslist, go under Craigslist, look under the free section and just find stuff. Go there and take it. A lot of people give stuff away for free, but if not, you can literally purchase stuff for $15, $20 and get started. You don't need to have a bunch of money to get started in any workout. There's so many like self bodyweight exercises you can do and just simple things offline. We have literally everything at the access of our phone. There's so many apps that give you so many personal bodyweight workouts that you can do. And you would be a fool not to take advantage of any of that. And then again, like if you're a kid, like for Christmas, I just asked for boxing stuff like this and a couple pairs of gloves, these bags or these pads and some boxing shoes. But slowly over time, you can build your home gym. And then I also wanna say, I'm sorry I haven't posted in a while. I just kinda got lazy. And I'll start posting more now that I got a new camera and then a new computer to edit on. But I just wanna say thank you for 100 subscribers. We reached 100 subscribers, which is kinda cool, I guess. And at 1,000 subscribers, I'm gonna give a brand new one of these bags away. I'm gonna order another one and I'm gonna send it to a random person when I hit 1,000 subscribers. So subscribe, let's get 1,000 so I can give away one of these, and probably 400 people watch that video, so if you might have like a really big chance of winning one, not winning one, just getting one, and I'll send it to you. I'll pay for shipping and everything. So I hope you enjoy this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.